This is my song, and no one can take it away. It's been so long, but now you're here, here to stay. And I wonder if you know what it means to find your dreams come true.
YouTube! Like, comment, subscribe for more thought-provoking content like this. Click the bell icon button. Welcome to Spirit of Detroit Podcast. I'm your host, Avery Giovanni, and this is Spirit of Detroit Podcast. This is a Lions-centric channel, but always we talk about the playoffs. Let's get in these matchups. I'm going to be the first to say it. Tom Brady's the GOAT. In 2016, I bet my boy Brandon that Tom Brady was going to win the Super Bowl. At that time, I was living in Ypsilanti, Michigan. I was going to school at Eastern Michigan University. I was walking on to the football team at that time. And before the game, I told one of my best friends, he asked me, who you going for? And I said, I'd like Atlanta to win, but I know Tom Brady's going to win the game. So, Tom Brady. The whole country loved the Rise Up campaign. The whole country loved the swag and the pop culture of the Atlanta Falcons. It was black culture. The Atlanta Falcons at that time was rocking. They was a high scoring team. They were electric. They could run it. They could pass it. They could do anything. Matt Ryan's career was revitalized. They were beating people in dramatic fashion. They were the highest scoring team, as well as a defense just pinned their ears back and got you with four. You had a good head coach with Dan Quinn, who's proven to be a capable coach. You had a seasoned quarterback, a decent running game, and great impact wide receivers. You had weapons everywhere. And I still pick Tom Brady. Because Tom Brady doesn't care about narratives. Tom Brady doesn't care about what a team looks like to pop culture. Tom Brady doesn't care about social media, the likes, the counts, the follows, the Twitter fear. He doesn't care about none of that stuff. Tom Brady is a 40-year-old quarterback, moving forward in society, light years ahead of himself. Tom Brady, when people say he's about to fall off a cliff, he always manages to finesse higher, to gain more. That game, by halftime, my friend called me and he joked that, like usual, per usual, you're wrong. I said, Tom Brady's going to win this game. I had no faith in Tom Brady. I was not a Tom Brady fan, but that last drive in the first half of the Atlanta Falcons game in the Super Bowl, that showed me enough. When he had that interception, he went to that sideline, and all he did was give a look. And then they end up scoring something, like a field goal. I'm like, okay, they're going to get back in this. I don't know how. But they're gonna get back in this. It's 28-3. Maybe they make it 25-3 and then figure it out then, or 25-28. But I had full confidence. Now, when I say I wasn't confident in Tom Brady, I wasn't one of these people that love Tom Brady. I actually hate Tom Brady. I hated him against the Rams when I was first introduced to the football, when there was Marshall Faulk and Kurt Warner and all these actual real Rams players. And I hated him against a lot of teams. Like, I really hated him. But against Atlanta, I seen Atlanta was a streaky team. They want to destroy you, dispose of you. And they couldn't dispose of that Tom Brady team. They couldn't dispose of the New England Patriots. And I already knew that was a great preamble to the second half. So my friend texts me, you know, he called me and then he texts me, "You're going to be wrong, man. Let's double up the bet." We doubled up the bet. And I couldn't get a hold of him the next day. Because Tom Brady doesn't go for these punchline narratives and these, "Oh yeah, he deserves a Super Bowl." He doesn't go for that shit. He will destroy you. Gronk, Tom Brady, all these guys went to Tampa Bay under the guise that they were going to win a championship. Fournette got cut by his team and he went where? To go get a championship. Antonio Brown got cut, went where? To get a championship. This is how you have a definitive quarterback. This is how you know there is no conversation. There is no, that's why I'm weird about golf fans. Like, Tom Brady's the GOAT. There is no conversation. We want to know if he goes to the Super Bowl. He's the favorite to go to the Super Bowl. I had a subscriber tell me, "Hey, this guy's this guy's going to the Super Bowl. I don't know what you're talking about. Green Bay's not going. This guy's going to the Super Bowl." Number 12 does not care about Stafford's feelings and all this other nonsense that the media tries to peddle. He doesn't care about why he left Detroit. He doesn't care about he had no weapons and all this other stuff. They finally, no, as long as this man is in, this is his shit. As long as he's in the playoffs, this is his shit. This is his shit. This is NFC, AFC champion. The only quarterback to win the NFC championship, the AFC championship, and Super Bowls for both two different teams. Come on, man. The only quarterback with six rings. Come on, man. What are we talking about? We're talking about Stafford and Odell Beckham, who combined won only one playoff game? No. It's over with. And I personally, I cannot take the Stafford, as a Detroiter, I cannot take the Stafford narrative anymore. I cannot do it. Because now that he's won against the lowly-ass Arizona Cardinals, and mind you, seven teams in the playoffs is unnecessary. That is unnecessary. Because seven teams in the playoffs, those teams did not need to be there. Arizona don't need to be there. The Philadelphia Eagles don't need to be there. We need to see competitive football. Arizona was nothing. That was nothing. That was clickbait. That was for y'all to like, "Oh yeah, okay." I figured he would get to this point. I was like Thanos or one of them superheroes. Oh, I figured this. Well, what happens after this point? What did Kang the Conqueror say? "I've always seen my life up until this point." Stafford ain't the guy to make to no. Levante David, Antoine Winfield Jr. No. Boy gonna throw three picks. I guarantee you, this dude is going to crumble under pressure because he's dealing with big boys. Tom Brady, with 2 minutes left, he's dealing with a whole game in the divisional round. Even if this was Aaron Rodgers and he had to go face Aaron Rodgers for one last time in Green Bay and under the same duress, he's not going to win. This is a different upper echelon of quarterback. This is a different mode. Right now, as it stands, the Bills quarterback has more playoff wins than he does. So why are we talking about this dude? Like, he just won something. He's a special ed Olympics quarterback. This dude is not the guy. I've never understood why Stafford fans just... I've never understood that. It was a nice run, Stafford. But this is his shit. But I want you to bask in this feeling. I want you to feel good about what you did this season. You won 12 games for the first time in your career. You had 4,800 yards for the first time in your career. You had, you know, an immense, you know, you led the league in three picks and you had immense offenses sometimes and sputtered offenses sometimes. But you won a playoff game for the first time in your 13-year career. I'm very proud of you, Stafford. You won a playoff game for the first time in your 13 years. You're 1-4 in the playoffs. Congrats. 1-3. But it's over now. I just want you to bask in knowing that you got here, knowing that it's possible to get to this moment, and knowing that on Sunday it's going to be over for you, and on Monday you're going to be trying to work out, and you're going to call your best wide receiver, and you're going to call your guys and get ready for the off season. Because Monday starts your off season. Because that's when it's a wrap. All that SoFi Stadium, billion-dollar stadium shit, all that hype, all that, all of the lights, it's over with. And all I can do is talk to you about next season, like I did here for 12 years in Detroit. Like, comment, subscribe. This is Avery Giovanni, Spirit of Detroit Podcast. As always, like, comment, subscribe. Love y'all. And I got 4 more videos coming out today. Understand. Be with me. We're rocking to the weekend. This is divisional matchup weekend. We are going to talk teams. If you're a Dallas Cowboys fan, I'm sorry. Y'all are hilarious. Your rage compilations are hilarious. Shooting at TVs and all types of shit is going on. So like, comment, subscribe. I'm Avery Giovanni. Love y'all.